And good day and welcome to all our YouTube viewers. I believe by the grace of God, you've been enjoying our YouTube broadcast. It's 10 minutes of GOFA. By the grace of God, our YouTube channel is about 2 weeks old. And last week, it showed on the topic, how to grow or start organizations. We focused on naming, and at the same time, we also focused on proper staffing for organizations. 10 minutes of GOFA is a program laid in my spirit to help organizational heads, people that want to go into businesses, visionaries, school owners, church owners, ministry, people in ministry, to know how to stand up, to know how to grow it, and at the same time sustain it. Today, our focus will be on money for business. Money for business. Now you have known how to get a name for the organization and how to source for your staff, it's good you know how to start. Money is one of the most essential commodities when it comes to business, because without money, business cannot begin. Now, people tend to ask, even on social media platforms, sir, how can I start a business when I have no money, when I have just a little, when the money I have is not up to what I have, what I envisage in mind? Now, the truth is this. One of the finest ways to start businesses or organizations is with your savings. Listen. Never you borrow money to start a business. The moment you borrow money to start a business, that business has the verge of giving you a heart attack, a hypertension, or the business might even die. Now listen, once you can think enough, what you have is enough. A man once said, start businesses with what you have and not what you want. So if I want to run a business of about ₦1 million and I have in my savings ₦200,000, that's the best way to start. Never you take a loan to start a business. Never you take money from people, from banks, microfinance organizations to run a business. Those things can only come in when the business has already taken a flight, at the middle of the business, or when the business has blown or so grown. The way you take money from people, organizations, daily contributors, whatsoever, whoever, to start up a business, listen, if that business does not work, if it collapses, it's not just going to have a hit on you, it's as well going to have a hit on the people, and they're going to come after their money. And when they come, you're going to run into debt. And when you're debt, when you're in debt, you're going to have sleepless nights, you're going to have torture, torment. So the shame that's going to be in 2 faces for you being the entrepreneur that failed, and secondly, the people that want to get their money back from you will also be disgracing. So you're having 2 disgraces on one platform. I beg of you, now you've known how to get a name for your business like we talked about last week, and you've also learned how to get the proper staffing. Please, money for business is best gotten from your personal savings. If you have not saved enough, hold on. Once the money you have in your accounts or your savings is reasonable enough, you start. Businesses that are so big today started small. Think big, yes, we know, but start small. Because if you start big, when the fall comes, the fall will be so loud. Imagine somebody falling from a 5-story building. The fall will be so loud. But when you start small, just from a down floor, a bungalow, the fall won't be too loud. I beg of you, all our listeners, if you've never known this before, it's a secret I'm unveiling to you right now. Never you take loan to start up a business. Start with what you have, where you are part-time or at that time, and the people around you. One of the finest ways to start businesses, I say it again, start with what you have, where you are at a particular time, and the people around you. I believe I've helped our viewers to learn something new this week. Watch out again for our weekly broadcast by next week, or shall bring you something new again about organizational growth, organizational management, and whatever God leads in my heart to speak on. God bless you. Please utilize the things you've heard, and I believe your business will see the light of the day and go bigger. Thank you very much. God bless.